By the end of this video, you're gonna learn how to use motion tracking, yes, motion tracking, in Wondershare Filmora 10. Keep watching! Hey everyone, it's JJ from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. The moment that you have all been waiting for is finally here. Motion tracking is available in Filmora! Motion tracking is when you track the movement of something in your video. A person, a hand, or even scenery. Once the movement has been tracked, you can add text or images or other objects that follow that same movement. We've seen motion tracking being used as animations, labels to follow a person or an object like in gaming, or to hide sensitive content. I'm gonna teach you how you can use motion tracking in Filmora 10 to make someone's name follow them. You can use this for a character introduction, to track an athlete during a game, or use it as a label for a character in gameplay. Now, let's see how it's done. First, drag the footage you want to apply motion tracking to into your timeline. Check that the subject you want to track is in frame for the entire clip. If they aren't, trim or cut to make sure that they are in frame. Next, it's time to apply motion tracking. Make sure your playhead is at the beginning of the clip before you start tracking. The tracking will start wherever your playhead is, so anything before it won't be tracked. So make sure that you have it at the beginning of the clip to have your entire clip tracked. You can open the motion tracking tool from the icon on the timeline toolbar or by double-clicking your clip and finding motion tracking in the editing menu. The tracking box will appear in the video preview. Move and resize it to select the object you want to track. Once that's done, click the Render Effect button and Filmora will analyze the footage. Now it's time to add the object you're going to have follow the track. Let's head over to the title menu. I don't want any preset animations on my text, so I'll just choose this default title, drag it to the track above the footage, and type in the subject's name. Next, I need to think about where I want this label to sit in relation to the subject. I also want to drag the edge of it to the timeline so the duration is the same as the footage. Right about there. Now that that's set up, I'm going to double-click the footage I've applied the tracking to and go back to the motion tracking menu. There's a drop-down menu here that will list all the text, images, and other objects available. I've only set up one piece of text, so that's all I'll see. And I'll choose that, which will set it to move with the clip we just tracked. I think I want it right above their head and I need to adjust the size. Let's watch it back. Pretty cool, and it was so easy to do. We're so excited to see what you guys create with motion tracking. What do you guys have planned? Make sure to send us the link of your video in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you guys next time.